Hi everyone, this is Muffin Alpha. Today I'm presenting a tutorial of a Christmas illustration with lettering. Especially for this, I created a set of brushes. They are free and they will be needed to create this illustration. At first, we create a new project and fill it with colorful background. It's dark blue. Then you should create new layer. When we start to draw a bag, we will do it bright red. To do this, we take the first brush and start drawing a roundless shape. At the top will lie the gift, so we make it slightly concave. The brush is slightly textured to have more lively effect. You should draw the main shape and then you can fill it with color and finalize the edges. So that's it. You can make it more rounded as you like. Next, we shall draw gifts, create layer under the layer with the bag. We draw shapes of gifts, each on another layer, because we will add shadows through the mask. Use colors from the palette. Second gift will be light pink. Draw the edges as if it were going further inland. The layer is lower, so don't be afraid to go in for a wide gift. The next box will be brown and square. Now we make the basic form, it simple. Let's draw the other side of the box. It will be dark brown. Then draw a small gift of a lighter color. And then make the bag gift itself dark brown. The main forms are ready. Now you can draw balls. They will be red, like a bag. We draw all balls at once and use simple shapes. this ball will be big, then the middle ball, and the small. Now we will add the snow at the edge of the bag. For this purpose, we create a new layer on the top, choose a white color and the brush named Fur. It's fluffy and suitable both for the edges and snow. Looks like real fur. Now our back is stand on the snow, and at the back we add dark blue color for the volume. First color, dark color. Ready? Now let's start lettering. Choose a lighter color and the brush for lettering. First, you should outline how the letters will be located and draw the base lines. And then on the top layer you should draw the letters. The point is that when we lead up without pressure, the line is thin, and down with pressure, the line becomes bigger. Try to make the slope of the letters equal. Add some flourishes there and there. Slide the lettering to the center. Write a second word. I moved it slightly to the right to fit the letter T. Let's add it. One more flourish. And that's it. Then we got our lettering. Remove the help lines, finalize with an eraser. Okay, let's now add a volume. Duplicate the layer with lettering, block the layer and fill with another color. Then remove the block and little shift. So Whoa. Got something like a shadow. To make it solid, add color in spaces. Make sure that the transitions were smooth. It turns out to be such a volume. We draw first word. Do the same with the second world. Carefully finish the edges. Up and down. Also, you can add another shadow by duplicating this layer, and almost nothing will be needed to be corrected. First, finish first one. Duplicate the layer and fill the bottom layer with dark color and shift a little. So this is it. Then I want to add the curls with the first brush. But the first we make our inscription in the center of the bag. First combine all the layers when our lettering and move it to the center. So now we can add curls. Fill in the blanks and add a vintage atmosphere. Here we go. Now we would finalize gifts. Add the shadows with the shading brush, starting with the bottom gift. Add layer, clip and mask, choose dark color and shading. Shade on the right side. You should also add a cover with the same mask. So we can see that somewhere there are gaps, and we improve from the bottom layer. Another option for adding shadow is to lock the layer and draw right on it. lock, dark color, shading, and draw very slightly. The same we should do with the rest of the kids. Don't overdo the shadow, because we'll then add more patterns to them. Add shadow to the pink gift, clipper mask, dark color and shading. To the brown gift, clipper mask, dark color. And a white gift. All this we do through the masks. Okay. Also with the clipping mask we also can add patterns the same way. Draw on the clipping mask and pattern will be seen on a gift. On this box we add a grid. We can do it more transparent so that it does not distract attention. On the top gift we can add these stripes and make the transparency of about 45%. Then we add the volume to the balls, make a mask, choose a dark color and shading brush. You can erase an extra color. The brush size you can choose little for the little bowl, and erase shadows when the lights are. Also you can add highlights. I do it on a new layer. Erase in the shadows. That's it. And let's do the same with the bag. New layer with a mask. Shading. And highlight with a light color. And small reflex. Then we add a little detail. It will be such tassels which are tied. Left one and the right one. You can erase it where the back comes in. Just in the left brush, more curly. That's it. placement. Then add new layer, mask, and make the stripes color red. And the right one. Yeah, I like it. It remains to make a background. To do this, let's create a new layer at the bottom. Then add the bokeh to the background with a brush glow. Not very much. And add decorative elements. I have snowflakes. You can make it bigger. Use different colors and sizes. Add stars, little one. More stars ever. Sometimes they can go over the contour of the bag. You can also add your own elements, like I draw, for example, these circles like this. And finalize. Our illustration. So that's it. I hope it was useful. Thank you very much.